Welcome back to MLB O9 Road to the Show. Right now, they put me in a clutch situation, I guess. And right now, we're in the bottom of the eighth with zero outs, and they brought me in as a pinch runner. I was hoping to get an at-bat in, but I guess I'll be running for someone. I'm assuming it's probably like someone slow, like the catcher or whatever. So, I probably won't get any playing time in the field. We'll see how this one goes, though.
To jump ahead to the bottom of
inning
number 8 now.
Let me fix this real quick. There we go. That works. I have not done any base running yet. I've not played this game in a long time. And I ain't career mode either, so I have no clue what to expect. Alright, well, apparently I don't know how I need to.
Only partially successful there. They got the lead guy to third, but couldn't get two men into scoring position.
Obviously, I need to work on how base running works in this game.
And we'll move forward now to the top of inning number 9.
Okay, I am playing defense. What position are you playing? That's what I'm worried about. If they put me in the outfield or catcher, I'm going to be pissed.
Three with a strikeout thus far.
I'm going to be really pissed if they put me in the outfield or as catcher. I'm playing shortstop, like last time. That's not the position I was playing.
3-1 is on the way. Lined into left center. Base hit.
That's not the position I was playing in there.
Okay. And now it'll rattle up against the wall.
I'm not even doing anything.
And he is in to second base with a leadoff double.
Not the way you want to start an inning on the mound, as he serves up a leadoff double right there.
Well, and the bats were certainly working in this one, but out of everybody, I'd say this man most deserves to be our upper deck player of the game.
Yeah, a couple of home runs in a ball game is pretty special. You could tell he was really dialed in up there, and he had a whale of a game.
So that brings us to the conclusion of this one. For my colleagues Dave Campbell and Rex Hudler and all of us here at the show, this is Matt Vaskirjian saying thanks for joining us here this evening. Once again, our final score. The Defenders win this one 6-3. This has been a presentation of MLB 09 The Show. For more information, log on to MLB09.com. So long, everybody.
All right, well, that was a waste of a game. I did absolutely nothing. Like, absolutely nothing in that game. So I'm just going to stop. I'm going to go straight to the next game. So we'll see what happens. Like, look, I was only a pinch hitter. Or, not pinch hitter, pinch runner. And I didn't do anything that game. I didn't do anything in the field. They didn't give me anything to do in the field, because the one thing they made me do is just run towards the outfield and not even catch the ball. Like, I didn't get a chance to catch the ball either. Like, nothing. Just give me a start or something. Come on. Pinch hit. Wow, pinch hitter. Cool. I better get a start eventually, right? I mean, come on. But this, obviously, I have to go clutch here with two out in the bottom of the eighth. And it's tied at 4. So obviously, this is a clutch situation I'm in. I don't know. Just hope for the best, I guess. What else can you ask for?
And welcome in, everyone. We're in the eighth inning here, already two men out.
The fact that both teams have 3 errors at this point, that's kind of scary. Alright. Be patient and look for the best
number 8
ball to
step in now.
I need a chance to play second base in the minors, yeah. That's the crazy part. I played second base all the time in the majors in spring training.
And that's high for a ball, 1-0.
I've had no chance to play second base with up here, really. Down here, like, double A. And I think it's only my like the third game they put me in, so.
Grounded foul.
Man, I'm swinging late. I think I need a better controller. It's not responding as fast as I want to. Yeah, very late. Oh, boy.
Fastball swung on and grounded out towards second. Throw in time and the side is retired. So no runs on one base hit, no errors, and no one left on.
At least Smashing didn't give me a...
We played 8 full, and we are tied 4-4.
At least I wasn't supposed to be giving the goal for Smashing that time, so I'm good with that. But, man, this is gonna be tough. Oh, come on.
Brian Pocock will dig in, needing to find a way to get that go-ahead run in from second base.
Please just be a ground ball to me. I swear, I'm going to be really upset if it's not a ground ball to me this time. We got a slow run at second, too, so he might as well just, he might stick.
Here's the 2-2 pitch.
Ah, it's pop-up.
And a high pop-up to the left side. Number
got
eight
it.
Is there. Two down. Time to hand out upper deck player of the game honors for this one. And guys, I think we can all agree that this fella right here deserves it more than anybody that took the field in this one.
Matt, he only had one hit in the game, but was it ever big? That home run really turned out to be the decisive blow in the game.
Might be the first time I've ever seen him.
So that brings us to the conclusion of this one. For my colleagues Dave Campbell and Rex Hudler and all of us here at the show, this is Matt Vaskersian saying thanks for joining us here this evening. Once again, our final score... The Fisher Cats can't get enough of that name. They win it 5-4. This has been a presentation of MLB 09 The Show. For more information, log on to MLB09.com. So long, everybody.
All right, I'll go do at least one more game. We'll see what happens. Like, if they let me start the next game I'm in, then maybe that's all I'll do in this episode. Because I'm getting a little tired of sitting on the bench for so long. I mean, been riding the pine, doing almost nothing. If I had more chances, I probably would have a better shot to get this done. Yeah, it's definitely been kind of boring, honestly. It's only my third game I've been playing in the minor leagues. So, I mean, I'm hoping to get more playing time. Eventually I'll get it, I know I will. But for now, it just seems like I'm not getting anything done. One put out, that's it. Let me look at the Blue Jays roster here. Yes, I'm on Blue Jays. Eventually I'm gonna make it to the AAA, right? Because I mean it'd be kinda sad if I don't eventually, right? That guy's in AAA, so I should be starting over these guys. They're not because they don't give me the option to do that right away. I'd have to wait. Yeah, alright, okay. Let's go straight to the next game. Or whatever game I end up playing. I don't know when. Hopefully it ends up being me starting. Wait, hold on, what's going on? That's 5 messages. Uh-oh. In the lineup. Oh boy. Okay, hold on. I'm going to advance rules. Oh god. I haven't done any training yet. I need to do that. That works. Button ability? Okay. One more. There we go. One. Okay. So now they're giving me a... So now, because of an injury... Gregory Hanley suffered an injury, pulled leg muscle, leaving our starting lineup short of amnesia to replace for the time being. Okay, so they gave me the. Hold on, I want to see. What the heck? So. Wait, what? They're putting me in as a catcher. You don't have a backup catcher, you guys? Oh my god. I'm not. This is. Why do you have the other catcher as DH? Oh my gosh. Well, that's confusing. But I finally got my second start. Apparently, I might be playing catcher. I don't know what. If I'm playing in the backstop, that's gonna be crazy. You know, my dream was to make it into baseball, but when I was younger. But the physical me, that's not gonna happen anymore. So this is the closest I get to trying to do it in real life. Whew, all right, let's see what we get.
With the skyline of Gotham behind us, MLB The Show welcomes you to the spanking new Blue River Stadium for this edition of Major League Baseball. Today we play game three of this four-game weekend series, as it'll be the New Hampshire Fisher Cats taking on the New Britain Rock Cats. And hi again, folks. Alongside Dave Campbell and Rex Hudler, I'm Matt Vaskersian, getting set for an intriguing matchup here. Rex, let's begin with you. What are you going to be keeping your eye on in this ballgame?
Well, double-A ball can take its toll on a lot of guys that don't have the mental toughness. This guy right here looks like someone that bears watching. Keep an eye on him.
All right, Rex, and we'll get to Dave shortly, but now we'll have a look at our starting lineup presented by Majestic. Number 7, who bat first here, a rare leadoff catcher. Number 23, bats second in left field. Number 8, bats third, he's at second. Number 70 will bat fourth and be the designated hitter this afternoon. Number 16 will bat fifth, he's at third base. Number 33 bats sixth and plays short. Howie Clark is at first base and in the number 7 hole. Buck Coates hits eighth, he'll be in right field. Number 0 will round out the lineup, he is in center. Number 25 will have the challenge of stopping these guys. This is a guy that's got a workhorse mentality out there, not afraid to throw a lot of pitches, but if he gets careless with his location, he can be hittable. Quickly, a look now at the defensive alignment they'll face in this one.
Okay, honestly, I'm a little shocked that I'm actually playing second base and I'm batting third. Now, they might have actually adjusted the lineup after I went and checked the lineup. So, that's interesting. Finally get started second base, and we'll see what we can do. Let's go.
Number 8, we'll dig in here.
It's my chance to finally try to make some noise, and we'll see what we can do here. Alright. What?
Field down to first. Yes, sir, says the first base umpire. Strike one.
Hate those. Why did they even try to go for it? See, what I should be doing is waiting for that first strike instead of making.
Runner at first here, one man out.
I should be waiting for that first strike instead of like swinging at the first pitch. That's so dumb.
Swing and he gets under this one as it's hit in the air.
Fall.
And he can't track it down. A base hit.
Whew. I'm not going for third, that's for sure. Or second, anyway.
But too late, and he's safe at third.
No hesitation that time, rounding second, as he's going to hustle all the way to third on the base hit.
I'm actually glad he stopped. I didn't want to go third now.
Take his first cuts of the ball game here.
I think I got lucky on that. I got lucky on that pitch right there. That's like, I got past him. Now, if it was Major Leagues, it obviously would have gotten me.
Him out with a fastball too low for ball one.
And even when you're missing low with a fastball, it can still effectively set up your other pitches.
I wish I could zoom out right now because I want to like see the field. I want to see
the
field.
Corners with one man out. Now the 1-0 pitch. And this one's too far inside, ball two.
Yeah, you're always looking to keep guys honest with fastballs on the inside part of the plate.
See, I need to be doing what this batter, my teammates do right now at the plate. Like I should have been letting pitches go instead of trying to go for it.
And there's the first strike, 2-1.
I guess I was just going too aggressive on that first at bat. I got lucky to get that hit, honestly, so I probably won't get lucky next time I do that.
Low here, so the count swells to 3-1.
I may, if it becomes a full count, I may try to steal second. I don't know for sure.
Runners are at first and third, one away.
Ooh, excuse me.
The 3-1 pitch. And he turns on this one and yanks it foul and back out of play.
Okay, it's a 3-2 count. I'm gonna stay. I'm not gonna run. If it was two outs, I'd run. It's only one out, though, so I'm not gonna run.
On the ground is short. This could be two. Throw
Not nearly in time as
nice job with the error. That's an E6 right there. E6.
Well, you had to figure sooner or later something like this would happen. I mean, this guy is no infielder. What'd they expect?
Number 16 will get his first shot at it here.
Uh-oh, I don't know, they got someone at the wrong position. Position that guy's not familiar with, I'm assuming. That's not good. You want to trade for me? I'll play shortstop. I can play shortstop. Just kidding.
And he takes a cold strike, 0-1.
And the infield's into double play depth here as a ground ball could get him out of the inning.
This is where I pretty much have to wait, because I don't really want to rush it here.
Hit hard but fouled off to the left, and that'll keep you honest as a third base coach.
Oh boy. This has probably been the longest episode to date so far. I'm glad you're back, honestly.
Swing and a liner towards
second. Run.
That's okay, it, we're gonna stop it there.
Happy birthday. This is just a gift. Down 0-2 and he gets one right down the middle.
Did he really get that one right down the middle? That's really funny. You're not supposed to do that in 0-2, you know.
At least throw a little cushion to work with.
As a pitcher, if you're up 0-2, you should at least like try to throw a waste pitch or something instead of just leading right down the middle like that. That was not a good idea. Oh man, this bases loaded situation is one out, thanks to an error. Thanks to an E6. That would have been a double play because I was not running. Right away, for sure.
Man, a fastball just misses. It's 1-1.
Also, it's 11 o'clock on the point, so. Yeah, have some fun with it. Alright.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. 1-2 now.
Uh-oh. Not the best thing if it's a 1-2 count. Not the best situation, 1-2 bases loaded, but you gotta remember, pitcher's in trouble, not the batter right now, because I mean, I know it's still gonna double play any inning, but we got 1-0 lead, so yeah, we're starting here.
Grounded to third, this could be two. The second for one.
No.
Relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. So one run on three hits, one error in the inning, and two left. On now to the bottom of inning number one. The Fisher Cats are out in front, 1-0.
At least I touched home plate. I'm good with
that. Now to the bottom of inning number one.
All right, now to the bottom of the first. Let's see. The first batter. Nice.
Joe Wilkerson will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first.
All right. First time playing defense at second base in the minor leagues. Let's see how this goes. On the opposite side of the actual second base. Let's see how it goes.
Hit hard towards second, but an atom ball right to him for the first down.
Nice job with the atom ball. All right. We might see a steal here. I'm gonna be surprised.
Number 20 will get his first opportunity now.
Okay, it's got Rhody. He's not that steal, so it's gonna be double play. He's set
now the pitch. On the ground to second base, this could be two.
One.
To second for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. No runs on a hit, no errors, and no one left. On now to the top half of inning number two. The Fisher Cats lead it 1-0.
I'm feeling good right now. That was good.
We'll jump forward in this one to the top of inning number two.
Put out an assist. I'm feeling good about this right now. Oh, yeah. All right. Finally, I get an RBI opportunity here. All right. Now, this time, I got to be patient. I got to be patient with this time. I don't swing at the first. Wait until the first strike comes by. This time, so that's my plan. This one.
Step in, a base hit in his last time.
All right. I'll be ready on this one, but I know for a fact I don't want to swing at the first pitch.
First pitch on the way.
Strike go by. like that.
And he starts him out with a strike on the outer half.
Maddie's living dangerously by working his fastball up in the zone like that.
Normally I would swing at that. This time I didn't because I said, wait for that first pitch, wait for that first strike.
At first and second. Using the fastball exclusively here, it's 0-2.
Matt, he better get a stool if he wants to hit those.
I guess that's a disadvantage being 5'7", because those high fastballs, they get me, like, a lot. Those are really high fastballs for someone who's 5'7".
That misses 1-2.
All right, 1-2. Not chasing the slider there, it's just like, so that pitch is in the way. Now, the question is, where is he going to put it next? What pitch is he going to use? Now, I always pick the same thing last time.
Just did get a piece of that one, so it stays alive here.
That probably would have been ball two, but I didn't want to take a chance there. It's a cutter up there. It's still a fastball.
Now a ball lifted in the air to
fall. Yes! Another lucky hit. Another lucky hit. Unbelievable.
Well, you can't fault location on that one. He got him to chase it, but he winds up on base anyway.
Number 70 will dig in. 0-1 with a run batted in thus far.
I got the RBI too, so that's a success. That is luck right there. I can't... The luck of this episode right now. That's been crazy.
Here's the first offering. Swing and a miss, 0-1.
And boy, his location has really been an issue in the inning. That pitch is right down the middle.
I get to start now because of an injury that happened to a player that's not the same position I was playing. And I may be starting the rest of the season, most likely, as long as I don't get set up to AAA.
Swing and a hard hit ball towards the hole. Throw on to first, right, gets him, and the side is retired. So it's 2 runs on 4 base hits, no errors, and a couple of men left on. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number 2. The Fisher Cats are out in front, 3-0.
This might take a while.
We'll move forward now to the bottom of inning number 2.
We only got to the bottom of the second? Oh my gosh, this is going to take a while. How long are we in this episode? Over 22
we'll
minutes, almost 23 minutes. Jeez, this is definitely going to take a while. I gotta fix the camera again so I was checking how long this episode is. Goodness gracious. The rest of this game better not take like 8 more minutes.
Throw to first is in time for the first down.
I'm doing good out here. For my first time in the lineup now, like officially, like getting on the card, like. Well, actually, I had to start before, but now I'm actually in the starting lineup.
Number
hopefully
eight,
permanently.
Be the batter. Couple of singles to his credit thus far.
Wow, just going 2-for-2, and that average has gone from 200 to start this game at Sarah's game to 429. Unbelievable. I'm assuming if I get a third hit here, I would probably go 500. But I'm probably going to just wait.
And a ball 1-0.
He'll try a different arm slot here to see if he can get him to chase.
I think coming into this game, for the season, I was 1-for-5. Now it's 3-for-7, I guess. So
here's the pitch.
And that hit would give me 500.
Cold strike at the knees, 1-1.
I don't chase those wild pitches.
4-1 our score as we play inning number 4.
Which one game is to go up here?
That's more of a slurve than a slider, but whatever it is, it's 1-2.
Man, I wasn't expecting for that slider to go back down the middle. Sure.
Here it comes.
I chased that.
Fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. So they breeze through this half of the inning. On now to the bottom half of inning number 4. The Fisher Cats lead it 4-1.
As soon as I hit the button to swing, I knew I was in that hit at that time. I knew it at that time. I was like, no, I'm not going to get it this time. Oh boy. We're 5-1. We're bottom of the fifth. And we have There are the first and second. Joe Wilkerson. And there's first and second on defense. Well, we're playing defense. Nobody out. So obviously we're gonna be looking for a double play at the middle. Let's see if we can get it. Unfortunately, I have to cover second. So the right side is gonna completely open. Now the pitch. Swing and a ball bounce back up the middle. There's one. Two. We got the double play. Now it's only a runner third. The rally is going to be hopefully gone up now.
A little unconventional, perhaps, but it does the job anyway. As a good turn, we'll get him the double play.
I love how my guys like it looked like a backward throw or something. I don't know. That's not the way you throw it, honestly. But whatever. All right.
Number 8 will dig in, looking for hit number 3 in the ballgame.
Let's try to stand a hot streak in this game. 2 for 3. This is obviously my best performance yet, so I'm good with that. Yeah, I definitely chased
the first pitch to him. And now a ball lifted in the air out towards center field.
I couldn't resist. That was too good a pitch.
There, and they breeze through this half inning as the side is retired.
I couldn't resist. That was too good a pitch to not swing at. I really couldn't resist. Now I'm 2 for 4, and I'm pretty sure I'm at 500 now. Actually, 333. Yeah. And this might be our last at bat here. We're top of the 8th. Still have 3-run lead, and we have runners at first and second, and one out.
Number 8 will stand in. Couple of singles in 4 trips this afternoon.
Worst case scenario, I ground to a double. Worst case scenario, ground to a double play. Best case scenario, 3-run blast. I'm hoping the latter happened, but I highly doubt it. I'm gonna assume that the I'm gonna try to get a walk here. Oh. No! You've got to be checking. No.
Go to the bag for one. Relay to first in time, and just like that, the side is retired. So no runs on 2 hits, no errors, and a runner left. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the 8th coming up. The Fisher Cats are out in front, 5-2.
And worst case scenario happening. So yeah, that's fun. Let's hope it doesn't factor into it.
And boys, probably a handful of deserving candidates for our Upper Deck Player of the Game Award. But Dave, what do you say we go ahead and give it to the guy that shut the door out of the pen?
Yeah, it's nice to have someone like this you can call on to finish things out for you, and that's just exactly what he did.
All right.
So that'll just about wrap things up here in this one. For Dave Campbell and Rex Hudler, this is Matt Vaskirjian saying thanks for joining us here this afternoon. Once again, the final score. The Fisher Cats can't get enough of that name. They win it 5-2. This has been a presentation of MLB 09 The Show. For more information, log on to MLB09.com. So long, everybody.
All right, so obviously it could have been a little bit better at the end. Yeah, that happens, I guess, but it was bad. Things like that are bound to happen. I mean, I was hoping it'd be better. It was good at the start, obviously, but I faltered the next. It was good the first 2 at bats. I got lucky. The next 2 at bats, I pretty much faltered. And I kind of knew that was gonna happen anyway. I'm just gonna look at these guys. Started a pretty good job. And, fourth save of the season for our closer. Rough game using 7 pitchers. Ouch. Alright, that's all for this episode, which has been, a long episode, for sure. See you guys later.